Episode 1845 is Stress Planning Your Meal.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people. Happy every day. It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood. And guess what? It is Wellness Wednesday. Come on. You know you want to feel really, really good. So it's time to work your life from the inside out. But the question is stress planning your meal? Let's dive in. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Yes, stay tuned. It is coming around the corner. Blinks, it's the Super Bowl of Create Your Now. I am excited. You know what we're talking about today with health and wellness? What we talk about with marriage and parenting and relationships and mindset and faith and where we're going in our lives and how we're getting there and, you know, can I get through this? All of this is going to be wrapped up in the AIM Academy. I am so thrilled and I cannot wait to get you the details so we can begin to start working together face to face, not just ear to ear, but face to face. So stay tuned because you're going to want to be in right at the beginning. Is stress planning your meal? Dr. Amen says this, what you eat impacts more than just your waistline. The quality of your diet directly impacts the quality of your life. Now, a lot of us would not even stop long enough to say, okay, well, what I eat impacts more than my waistline. Most of the time, that's where we're stopping. It's like, have you seen my thighs? Do you know what my butt looks like? Oh, and my waistline? Well, I don't have one. Right? That's where our whole idea of nutrition falls. Do I have big arms? Do I have, okay, our chest, certain sizes, et cetera, right? We want to lose the weight. That becomes the focus. But little do we realize that it impacts something much greater, the quality of your life. Now, there's so much information out proclaiming exactly what you should fuel your body with in order to get the greatest results. So depending on who you speak with, you could literally have a book of different things to eat when and how much. Suggestions go as far as timing and how many meals in your day. Have you ever heard of eating six little meals a day? Some even say eight meals a day. I'm thinking, if I had to cook eight meals a day, I would be going crazy. I'm just saying. No wonder most of us are confused and we give up before we even really start. So how do you structure the quality of your diet in order to create the quality of your life you desire? Well, you got to fuel from the ground up. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Fuel from the ground up. In all the research and studies I've read, along with personal experiments on myself, oh yes, I'm my own test subject, the best way to eat, no matter what diet you want to follow, like the keto, the paleo, the whole 30, I mean, you just can rattle them off, right? One after the other. You must fuel from the ground up. And what I really mean by that is think of the ground and you're going to fuel from the ground up. So number one, you start with green vegetables and end with fruits. So if it grows in the ground, if it's on the ground, if it's in the ground and it's green, you want to eat lots of greens. Just start there. Greens are good for the body. It's nutritious. There's antioxidants. There's fiber. There's so many good things that you can't get in anything else. If you can handle kale, go for kale. If you can't, go to spinach. If you can't do that, go to romaine lettuce. Those are kind of your basic three, kind of the three tier. And if you're not sure what you like, then just try a little bit of it. You can always buy a bag of lettuce. Instead of buying a lot of something, buy one of those ready-made lettuce bags. Try it. See if you like it. Experiment a little bit with it and then end with fruits. And what I mean by ending with fruits, we get so bombarded with this whole thing of eat five fruits and vegetables a day. And we're sitting here going, I have to eat five fruits and I have to eat five vegetables. Well, you know what? It's real easy for me to eat fruits. Why? Because they're sweet. Anything sweet is easy to eat. And so we may sit here and eat five fruits or six fruits or seven fruits, and maybe you're lucky to get in one vegetable. You need to flip-flop that. You need to eat more green vegetables and sprinkle with fruits. So yes, you need fruits. They have something that's very beneficial in them. However, in my opinion, yes, you can overeat anything, but especially fruits. Why? Because there's sugar in there. And depending upon how your body can handle sugar, it may be something you have to be very cautious with. So just because the rule of thumb is eat five fruits and vegetables a day, that doesn't mean you need to overeat them. So eat lots and lots of greens. Half of your plate should be green. Seriously, greens, vegetables, yummy, yummy goodness. And then end with sprinkles of fruits. And I love berries. Your blueberries, your raspberries, your blackberries, strawberries, all of those are awesome. And then you could go into some other fruits, but you have to watch it depending upon your body. And this is where the AIM Academy comes into, right? Because it's hard for us to go individual right here, but you are so unique that you need to figure out what you need for your body. And most of us, we're like, I don't have time for that. Just tell me what to do and I'll do it. But we need to make time to do that. And in the AIM Academy, you're going to be able to figure out all of these cool details and not get flustered and really live the quality of life that you deserve. So start with green vegetables and end with fruits. Number two, add a protein that complements your activity level. Now, you cannot just produce protein in your own body. You have to eat it in order to have it. So it's very important if you are resistance training, strength training, and you're doing it 3, 4, 5 times a week, you better be putting in your protein. You gotta eat it because otherwise you can have serious complications. Now, just like with anything else, yes, you can overeat protein, but most of us cannot physically do that. Some guys maybe, but us women, it's kind of hard to. Why? Because usually we start to feel either way too full or sick before we can really get to that level of not so good on the amount that we're eating. So don't worry about that part of it. But on your activity level, if you're one who's like, okay, I'm kind of sitting around not doing a whole lot, then you don't want to eat a whole lot. Because why? You're not burning calories. You're burning some to sustain, but you're not burning it as if you are working out hard. When you go out and you do a strength training and you're sitting there doing 45 minutes to an hour, and I know some people who do an hour and a half, you have got to replenish your body. If not, you're tearing it down and you're giving it no way to build up. And when you work out and you're using your dumbbells or you're using resistance training, doesn't matter if it's actual weights or if it's resistance like bands or your own body weight, you're tearing down your muscle. When you tear it down, what does it have to do? It has to repair itself. Well, you need to repair it with what? Protein. And if you're not taking it in, your muscles cannot do what it needs to do. So make sure you're eating good protein. And think of it from what? Fuel from the ground up. So if you're thinking of the ground, think of what? What's below the ground? Ocean. I know you would say probably more dirt, right? No, I'm thinking even further than that. You've got the ocean, right? Beneath the ground. So you want to make sure you're also eating some fish, your salmon, yummy, goodness. You've got to get those omega-3s in from solid foods 2, 3, 4 times a week, and then work your way up, right? So what happens to a chicken when they lay their eggs? It's on the ground normally, or you can think of it like that, right? It comes down to the ground. So your eggs, a great full rounded protein that you can have, great carbohydrates and fat, all wrapped in one little kind of oval like circle, sort of weirdly, right? So it's your egg. That's your ground up. Then you go up from there and you think of what? Yeah, your poultry. And then you go up to your red meats. So really when you start thinking of the basics, and you're eating real raw food here. Now, you don't have to, I mean, cook your food, but real and raw, meaning that it's not just junk, right? You're not eating this weird stuff that it's called a hamburger, but you look at it and you're like, there's no way that's a hamburger. Like, it's overprocessed. I'm talking about you're eating the real good stuff for your body, because then your body can recognize it. And then what that allows your body to do is to rejuvenate itself when you're sleeping and to feed it just as you need it so you can be your best selfie. So add a protein that complements your activity level. And I'm sure you're asking too, well, about how much is that? Make a fist, look at your fist. If you're kind of moving on average, you're not like really killing yourself, that's about 4 to 6 ounces right there. If you're killing it one day, you may want to bump it up to 6 to 8 ounces. And guys, you can go 8 to 10 and sometimes 12 ounces, depending. Now, I'm not saying every single meal you're eating 10 to 12 ounces of protein, but for some individuals, that would be appropriate, not for most. So again, you have to know your body and what works right. Number 3, hydrate like a high tide. I love this. I was thinking of the ocean when I was writing it. I'm like, oh yeah, the high tide. It just what? It keeps coming in and coming in. You need to be drinking your water. Most of us are walking around dehydrated. That is not good. You cannot replenish your cells. And if you're not replenishing your cells with hydration, then it can't get what you're putting in it. So those wonderful fruits and vegetables and proteins, it doesn't know what to do. It falls flat because it's not hydrated. And it's like, oh, I can't do this. I'm barely surviving here. So it goes into survival mode and it kicks out what it really doesn't need because it's too tired. It's overworked, underpaid, right? So you've got to hydrate those cells. Think of the high tide and hydrate. It's time to drink it up. Now, some would leave you with those 3 tips and say, good luck. That's a great place to start. Yes, it is a great place to start, but there's still more you can do to fuel from the ground up. And that comes from the nourishment of yourself, not just in body, but in mind and spirit. It's the psychological, spiritual, relational, biological, educational, and vocational areas of your life. Fuel from the ground up includes the mind, body, and spirit. It's not just about the food. It's nourishment for your whole self. Now, you're probably going, okay, that sounds all fine and dandy. I got the other stuff, but now you're talking about this, and it really kind of freaks me out because I'm not doing so well in some areas. I'm sure when I mentioned that, immediately something came to mind. Maybe you are letting stress plan your meals. You're tired. You're overworked. You're in a season of life where you've got young children hanging all over you. Welcome to motherhood. We all go through it. It can be the best years of your life, or it could be those that you're just like, lock me in a closet, I'm done. And I don't want you to get to that point. It's not good for your whole well-being. And that's what we're looking at when we're talking about wellness. It's your whole well-being. So your challenge today is to assess where you are in the nourishment of your life. Begin with the basics. Yes, those basic 3, the food, the water, right? Your protein, your veggies, and your fruits. What does that look like in your life? You probably quickly can answer those. Most of us would say, I need to drink more water. You want a quick tip on how to drink more water? I'm all for the earth, but a couple different ways for you to keep track of it. If you're one who's drinking 4 to 5 glasses of water a day, but you need to increase that, then go out and buy your water bottles. Number them, 1 through 4, 1 through 7, however many you need to be drinking a day. Put them in there and start with number 1 at the beginning of the day and work your way through. You want to get by the end of around 7 o'clock at night to be done drinking your water. And if you're one who has to go to the bathroom a lot because you're not used to drinking that much water, I would up it that most of your water needs to be drunk by 5. Now, that doesn't mean you can't drink water later. You just don't want to try to gulp down a liter of it between 5 and bedtime, because that's a lot and you may have to go to the bathroom more and you really need a good night's sleep. You don't want yourself waking up because you have to go to the bathroom. You see that horrible cycle you can get on? So deep breath, look at your water, take water bottles and number them. Now, maybe you have plastic water bottles that are reusable at home already. Then fill them up and number them. If you don't want to write on them, then use painter's tape or masking tape. Stick it on there and write a number 1, 2, 3. Start at the beginning drinking with 1 and go through the day. Measure it. Then before you go to bed, refill them all up, have them ready in the refrigerator and start at 1. You will eventually find that, oh my gosh, this is great. Now, some of you are like, okay, I'm really not into getting all those water bottles and is there another way? Yes, there is. Get yourself a gallon. Empty it out, or you can use a pitcher, whichever you have. Maybe you have an old pitcher that you used to make Kool-Aid with and no longer, I used to have those forever, and now I'm not really using those much. So pull it out of the cabinet and mark it at 10 a.m. I need to, and at the very top, you mark 10 a.m. This is how much water I need to have drunk by 10 a.m. Then mark 12, noon. It needs to go down to here, 2 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock. And you just keep moving it down. If you get one that is basically equal to a gallon or approximately 2 to 3 liters, then guess what? There's your measurement. Because ultimately, you want to drink half of your body weight in ounces of water. So to make the numbers easy for us to figure out, if you weigh 150 pounds, half of that is what? 75 pounds. So you want to drink 75 ounces of water in a day. Now, some of you are like, but what if I weigh 200 or 250? I have to drink over 100 ounces of water. Deep breath. I would start out a little bit lower and then work your way up. The more water you drink, guess what? The better hydrated you are, the better it is for you to flush out all the crud. And if you are overweight and your goal is to lose weight, this is one of the best things you can do in creating new habits that will help fuel your healthy lifestyle. Okay, so back to the nourishment of your life. Begin with the basics, your food. Water, hydrate, right? These are your basics. Your protein. Make sure you're getting protein every single meal and snack that you have, along with your veggies and fruits. Veggies, eat with every single time. Every single time you have food, you need to have veggies. Fruits, I would prefer and would recommend to you before 2 o'clock in the afternoon. And for me personally, I do only in the morning when I have fruits. I don't always do fruits. It depends on my workout schedule and what I'm doing. So you kind of have to begin to listen to that. And when you come into the AIM Academy, this will be one thing that we will be working on. There's lots of exciting things happening within the AIM Academy. So if you're great in one area, but you're weak in another, I promise you, you're going to find an area that you're like, okay, I'm all in here, but oh, I've got this down. So it's going to be fun. I promise you, it will be a blast. Then, after you assess, starting with your basics, then lean into the deeper assessment, your mind, body, and spirit. Look at yourself from a psychological point of view. Are you more flustered? Are you frustrated and angry? Do you just have an edge to you? Like things aren't right for whatever reason. Maybe you're overly stressed. Maybe relationally, you're having issues with your spouse. These are things not to beat yourself up over, but it's to understand what's going on. Because whether you want to admit it or not, your body is reacting to that. And if we are all putting ourselves under this extra stress when it comes to our psychological or our spiritual or relational, whatever area that you're looking at, it's tough. And your body's in always what? Fight or flight. Remember the question at the beginning? Is stress planning your meal? Most of us would answer yes to that if we were honest. I know I do. I came home yesterday and we went to the dentist and I was doing some stuff with classes and I was working on the AIM Academy and it was just like one thing after another. My husband called and said, "Hun, can you do this for me and that for me?" And I'm like, I'm fine doing it all, right? It's not a problem. However, it just felt like, whoa, I just need to sit down and do what I needed to do, but I needed to do 20 other things for everybody else. And so when it came time for dinner, I was standing at the refrigerator going, "What do I fix for dinner?" And I could just feel the intensity in my stomach going, "I really don't want to cook tonight. I'm tired. I've done a lot, but I know I need to feed my family. And I know it needs to be more of a healthy meal. What can I give them that's not going to stress me out, but it's going to fulfill the needs of my family, right? It's going to nourish us from the inside out." Well, it's a tough thing, and we are all stressed out. But if we begin to learn how to handle it little bits at a time and we know the areas in our life, then we can take a step back and we can plan accordingly. So really, as you go throughout your day, be aware. The self-awareness. I want you to be really honed in on it. Extra sensitive to it. If you find yourself tightening up or you have this, you know, I don't know, this tightening on your face, look at yourself in the mirror. Even if you're driving, look at yourself in your rearview mirror and go, "Oh my gosh, I can tell my face is tense. I must be stressing about something. What is it? Think about it. What is it?" If you have time, pull over and figure it out. Make note of it. These are important things to begin to walk through. This is all about training for life. If you want to live a healthy lifestyle, and you want to have a quality of life that goes beyond just waking up in the morning, doing your responsibilities, fulfilling those commitments, and then going to bed. Oh, wait, there's laundry and, you know, dishes and maybe a few children and a spouse in between all of that. And then you go to bed and get back up and start all over again. Yeah, you need to look at the details of your life, your whole life, your whole self, mind, body, and spirit. Deep breath, I believe in you. And you can do this. And I promise you, as you begin to work through it, it gets easier. So today, fuel from the ground up. Go out, train for life, and love your journey. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.